Now we will move to the second part. So here we will create a new file, then we will go to the sketch and select the top plane. After that we will insert a center line, a vertical center line. Now first we will draw a circle and then we will draw a vertical line like this, and a horizontal line, and again a vertical line. Now we have to give the dimensions. For that, go to the smart dimension. Now here the circle is having the diameter of 140 mm, and here the length of this line is 225 mm, and also here this line is having the length of 40 mm. After that we will trim out some unwanted portion. For that go to the trim entities and we will trim out this portion and then click on OK. Now we will exit the sketch and here go to the features and select the revolve boss feature and then click on the OK. Now after that we will make a plane. So here go to the reference geometry and select the plane. Now here select the surface. Now here we have to give the distance of offset distance. So here in this case it is 120 and we have to flip the direction. So click on the flip offset and then OK. After that we have to sketch. So go to the sketch and select the sketch. Now we will draw two concentric circles. For that select the circle and draw two concentric circles. Now we will give the diameters to both the circles. So here this circle is having the diameter of 80 mm and this circle having the diameter of 80 - 16 mm. And then we will click on OK and exit the sketch. After that go to the features and select the extruded cut, and the depth of extrusion is 10 mm, and then click on OK. Now we have to make the threads on this portion same as the eye rod. Before that we will give the fillet. So click on the fillet and select this edge, and here the radius of fillet is 5 mm, and OK. Now we will give the chamfer at these two edges and this edge. For that go to the here we will select the chamfer. Now select this edge and this edge, and here the distance of chamfer is 5 mm. So enter here 5 and then OK. Now we will make the threads on this portion. For that first we will go to the sketch, then select this surface. Now we will draw a circle having the diameter of 80 mm. So here draw a circle and then give it the diameter as 80 mm. Now we will exit the sketch. After drawing a circle we have to go to the features, then select the curves, and here select the helix and spiral. And here also there are same data, which is pitch of 8 mm, revolution of 15 and start angle as 0, and then click on OK to generate the curve. After generating curve we have to draw the profile of the thread. For that go to the sketch, then select the top plane. Now we will draw the profile of the threads. For that select here polygon. Now here the number of sides as 3, and then here we have to select at the end of the curve and draw a triangle like this, and then OK. Now we will modify this triangle. For that first select this edge, after that here select the vertical and then OK. Then go to the smart dimensions, and then here we have to give this length as a 8 mm. I'm sorry, here we have to give the distance in between the vertex and the center point of the circle. So that select this and this, and here this distance, I'm sorry, we have to delete this. So here first we will delete it. After that go to the smart dimension, then select this vertex and the center of the circle, and this distance is 8 mm, and then OK. Now we will exit the sketch. After drawing the profile and the helical curve, we will go to the features and select the swept cut feature. Now here we have to first select the profile. For that we will select this sketch in which we have drawn the triangle, and second one we have to select the path, which is the helix. So here we will select the path. Now after selecting these two, the preview of the swept cut is shown on the screen, and then click on the OK to make the threads on that portion. So here our second part is also completed, and now we will save it. So here we have created a folder on the desktop which is the ball joint, and we will name it as a ball end, and then click on the save. Now after making these two parts, we have to make the assembly. For that we will go to the file and click on the new. Here select the assembly and then OK. So now here first we will insert the eye rod, and then we have to insert the second component, which is the ball end. Now after importing the second component, click on the mat, then select this sphere, and after that select this inner sphere, and then click on OK here. Now we can also revolve the second part, which is the eye or eye rod, like this, and then click on OK. I'm sorry, we have to delete this and then click on OK. So here we have made the assembly of the ball joint assembly. Thank you. If you like my video, then please hit on the like button and subscribe my channel SolidWorks Tutorials. Thank you.